In this video, we shall refer to the second criteria to determine whether a series converges or not. It is rather difficult to make use of this criteria by its own. Therefore, we also present two more tests as a supplement. They are called the integral test and the P-series test. The second test, shown here, applies for series with positive terms. It states that let an be greater than 0 for all n, then this series converges if and only if the sequence of partial sums Sn, which is a sequence containing all the partial sums of the series, is bounded above. The reason that this test holds is as follows. Since all the terms of the series An is positive, therefore, the sequence of partial sums Sn is strictly increasing because this sequence is formed by all the partial sums of the series starting from S1, S2, and so on. The difference between the terms in this sequence and the preceding terms is Sn plus 1 minus Sn, which is equal to An plus 1, and it is positive. Therefore, this sequence is strictly increasing. In order that the series converges, we need to make sure that the limit of Sn when n tends to infinity converges. Since Sn is a strictly increasing sequence, this converges as long as it is bounded above. Otherwise, this sequence diverges. Therefore, we have the conclusion from test 2 here. Let's refer to the following example. We would like to determine whether each of the following series is convergent or not. For the first series, it is not a geometric series and it is not a telescoping series. Let us consider the limits of an when n tends to infinity to see whether it is zero. If it is not zero, then by the term test, we can conclude that this series diverges. However, here, when we consider the limits of an when n tends to infinity, this is equal to zero. Therefore, by the term test, we cannot conclude whether or not this series converges. It may converge or it may not converge. We need to make use of some other test to determine whether this series converges. Now, since the term an, which is equal to 1 over 1 plus n squared, is greater than 0 for all natural numbers n. Therefore, by the second test, this series is convergent if and only if the nth partial sums of the series, that is Sn, which is given by this formula, is bounded above. However, it is rather difficult for us to think of a closed form formula for Sn for this series. So in general, the difficulty is that usually we cannot find a closed form formula for Sn in terms of n. So it is rather difficult for us to directly use the second test to determine whether Sn is bounded above or not. The following two tests will be more helpful. First, let us introduce the integral test. It says that let f, which is a function which maps elements from this half-open interval to elements in the set of real numbers, be a positive, decreasing, and continuous function, such that its output value when x equals to n is equals to an. Then this series converges if and only if the integral of fx with respect to x from x equals to 1 to x equals to infinity is finite. In other words, if the integral here is finite, then this series converges. If this integral is not finite, then this series diverges. So, we can calculate the integral here to conclude whether or not a series converges. The following is the reason why this test holds. First, we explain the reason why if this integral is finite, then the series converges. The reason is that we can first refer to this figure here. We can see that the integral here represents the area of the region under the blue curve from x equals to 1 onwards. Then the sum of all the areas of the rectangle here represents the value of f2 plus f3 and so on. Since fn equals to an, this also represents the sum a2 plus a3 plus a4 and so on. We can see that the area of the sums of all the rectangles here is less than or equals to the area represented by this integral. So first we have this inequality. Please notice that the term a1 or that is f1 is missing here, but f1 or a1 is a finite value, so we can add this back to both sides of the inequality. Therefore we get this inequality. Now since this integral is finite, therefore the sum of this integral plus a1 is also finite. Therefore, this sum is now bounded above by a finite value. And we notice that this sum is the sum of a1, a2, a3, and so on, whereas the nth partial sum of the series, which is Sn, is equal to the sum of the first n terms. Therefore, this value is always less than this value, and this value is now bounded above by a finite number. It means that Sn is also bounded above. Therefore, by the second test, S1 is bounded above, therefore, the series converges. Next, we explain why if the integral is not finite, then the series diverges. We can refer to another diagram shown here, where the integral still represents the area of the region under the blue curve and from x equals to 1 onwards. So this integral represents the area here. Whereas f1 plus f2 and so on represents the area of all the rectangles here, and the first one has the height f1, and the second rectangle has the height f2, and so on. We can see that the area of all the rectangles summing together is always greater than or equals to the area of the region which is represented by this integral. Therefore, we have this inequality. The right-hand side is also equal to summing all the terms of the series, and it is greater than or equal to this integral. Then you can see that if the integral is not finite, then this series also diverges because its sum is greater than or equal to this integral. Now, let us refer to the same examples that we have come across before and use the integral test to determine whether each of the series is convergent or not. Let's refer to part A. Here, we can suggest a function with fx equals to 1 over 1 plus x squared. Then this function is a positive, decreasing, and continuous function, and the term an here equals to the output value of the function when x equals to n. It is 1 over 1 plus n squared. Now, if we evaluate the integral of fx with respect to x from x equals to 1 to x equals to infinity, we get the value pi over 2 minus pi over 4, which is a finite number. Therefore, by the integral test, the series is convergent. Please make a pause here and try to attempt part B by yourself, and we shall discuss the solution afterwards. Let us refer to part B of this example. Here, we can suggest a function fx equals to 1 over x times natural log x. So this function is a positive, decreasing, and continuous function. Also, the term an equals to fn, which is 1 over n times natural log n. Let us evaluate this integral, integrating fx with respect to x for x equals to 1 to infinity. We find out that this integral is not finite. Therefore, by the integral test, the series diverges. For part C and part D, we can use the similar strategy to deduce whether this series converges or diverges by the integral test. That is, we can evaluate the integral of the function fx with respect to x, where x starts from 1 to infinity, to see whether this is a finite value to conclude whether the series converges or not. These two series are series of the form summation of 1 over n to the power p, where n starts from 1 to infinity. We have a special test for series of this form to conclude whether this series is convergent or not, and we shall mention this test in the following slides. The following test, which is called P-test or the P-series test, is particularly used for series of this form, summation of 1 over n to the power p, where n starts from 1 to infinity and p is a real number. It says that for a real number p, this series converges if and only if p is greater than 1. Please refer to the following proof of this test by yourself, and the idea is that it makes use of the integral test to consider the integral of the function fx equals to 1 over x to the power p with respect to x, where x starts from 1 to infinity, to see for which interval of p the values is a finite value or it is not finite, and it helps us to conclude whether the corresponding series converges or not. Therefore, with this p series test, whenever we come across series of this form, we do not need to make use of the integral test ourselves, but we can directly make use of this test to conclude whether our series converges or diverges. Please make a pause here and try to make use of the P-series test to attempt the example part C and part D, and we shall discuss the solutions afterwards. Now, let's refer to part C of the example. We can see that this series has the form here, where p equals to 1. Since p is not greater than 1, therefore, by the p-series test, this series diverges. Whereas for part D, this is again a series of this form where p is 1.1, which is greater than 1 this time. Therefore, by the p-series test, this series is convergent.